I thought it might be nice to talk about something I've seen people have been talking about for the past couple weeks, and that's healing, how we heal ourselves in the game.
Great.
So can you first, I guess, take us through the history, you know, when we started talking about the game, creating the game, how you decided to heal yourself?
Well, I mean, there were a couple important factors. Like, one, we wanted to move in the direction of not having to do lots of like low-level like health management in the game. We wanted the player to feel like, okay, like I can be shot at and there's gun battles and that happens and everything's fine as long as I don't take too much damage, like in too short a time. And if that happens, then we're like, well, instead of just being dead, you should get wounded and you should have to deal with the repercussions of being wounded and having this life-threatening injury while you're in the sort of intensity of battle. So we created this wound system where, you know, when you take too much damage too quickly, we detect what caused the damage, like say it was a gunshot or a fire or an explosion or whatever, and then we have this library of about probably about 60 animations we'll have in the final game. We only have about 12 now, just to prove that the system works. And what will happen is you'll get a wound, and you'll need to get to cover and heal that wound by, you know, pulling a bullet out of your leg or putting out a fire somewhere on your body or you know, pulling a piece of shrapnel or something out of your torso or whatever it happens to be. So the idea is to really there's two important things. One is to create a really strong bond between the avatar and the world. If the avatar feels like he's really connected to the world, you know, with all of his animations, like getting in and out of a vehicle, switching back and forth with the gun, like all of this stuff is really heavily animated to make the avatar feel in place in the world. Because what that does is it sort of psychologically makes the player feel in place in the world. And then when we throw these wound animations into the mix, what happens is the player gets this sort of shocking exposure to this wound, which is sometimes a little disturbing and uncomfortable, and the pain of the physical wound sort of psychologically transfers itself back up that same pipeline that we've created between the player and the avatar, but it's a feedback now that comes directly to the player, and he feels just a sort of a psychosomatic response to the physical injury. It makes him feel the pain.
It also goes back to the immersiveness where, you know, we're having the minimal HUD, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
So again, no health pack. So it's about you're either okay, you're not okay, or you're really, really not okay.
Yeah, I mean, that's the whole point, is I don't need to know that I have, you know, what's the difference between having 86 health and having 76 health? There isn't really a difference to the player. You could say, yeah, but you can get shot with one more bullet. But when guys are firing machine guns at you from every direction, you don't know how many bullets you're getting hit by, even in a shooter that gives you all of the information about what percentage your health is at. What we wanted was to just say, okay, we want the player to know that he's fine. We want the player to know, okay, slow down and be a little bit more careful, or you're not going to be fine. And then we want the player to know you're in big trouble. You have to deal with this problem immediately, or you're going to have to reload the game. Mm-hmm. So you know, those are basically the three states we felt needed to be communicated. We didn't need the 1% granularity in order to communicate that.
Okay. Well, cool. Thanks. It's lunchtime, so we're really hungry. We wanted to get this out to you soon. So, as always, if you have any questions for us, comments, suggestions about what you want to see us talk about on the devlog, make sure you go to the devlog or the forums and give us your feedback. So, thanks, Clint.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks. See ya.